Before we start this, Javed sir, because you've had the pleasure of knowing Lata Mangeshkar ji personally and have done so many songs with her, and since this started with a tribute to her, can we ask you, request you please to say a few words about her?
It's so difficult and so easy to talk about her. You know, it's difficult because there are no words made in any language to describe people like Lata Mangeshkar. How do you describe what kind of a writer Shakespeare was? What words you use to describe Michelangelo's sculptures or Beethoven's symphonies? I think their name is their praise. She was Lata Mangeshkar. That is everything. But I think to become Lata Mangeshkar, I have been very fortunate. She has sung a lot of my songs. Besides that, I had a very close friendship with her. Friendship, obviously, she was much senior to me, but a very kind elder who would give me a lot of liberty. And she had a very sharp sense of humor. Not many people know, because in public her demeanor was very sober and dignified. She would only open up in a very close company. But I think to become Lata Mangeshkar, it is not enough to have a good voice and right key. You need many more qualities. That dedication, that dignity, that focus. I mean, in her whole career, she was so conscious of text. She used to give, generally, singers are very happy with their voices or if they are touching the right note. But for her, this was something which was taken for granted. What was important was the text. And she would really give a lot of, if she wrote like one word in a song, she would think that it's not dignified enough or decent enough. She would refuse to sing that song. Whoever may have written it, whoever may be the music director or the director or producer, that was not the criteria. She was so careful of this. And I have recently in an interview, so I'm repeating myself what I'm saying. She's the only singer I know who could sing the subtext of the song.
Wow.
You know, there are words. I'll give you an example. And when you go home, play that song again. You know, in Nahi Ranja there is a song, Tere Liye Hame Jiye. Oto Ko Siye. Now the situation is that the lovers are meeting after perhaps 20 or 25 years. Their hair is grey, they have wrinkles on their faces now. Everything is gone, everything is lost. But the song is not saying it. The song is Tere Liye Hame Jiye, Honto Ko Siye. It could be 6 months. It could be 1 year. That parting, that pining. But when you hear that song, you feel that it is a matter of decades. It's not a story of months or years. That subtext, that sense of defeat, that feeling that everything is lost, is gone, it's the past, which can never come back, is in the voice, in the tiredness of the voice. The voice that has surrendered to such circumstances. Now, how do you define that? I don't know. How she used to achieve it. And I can give you many examples. She would understand the subtext of the song and internalize to an extent that it would come in a voice. Sounds strange, but that is what Lata Mangeshkar was. She was strange. You can't describe her because, you know, in our houses, in our household, we don't keep things which we may use after 50 years or maybe once in a lifetime. We don't keep those things. Same way, languages don't make words which are not going to be used every day, which you may need perhaps in 100 years. So they don't make those words. So words to describe people like Lata Mangeshkar or Shakespeare or Beethoven or Michelangelo, no language has bothered to make those words because they know that they won't be used every day. Why keep them?